Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.2 was released to the public today. If you have a device that supports iOS 13 or iPadOS 13, your device is supported and you'll be able to install this right now. Now this came in at 587.6 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it can vary depending on device. And also if you're coming from the beta, it's going to be a very large install. In fact, the beta will be somewhere around 3.69 gigabytes. And if you're not seeing this update and you are on the beta, you'll need to remove that beta profile. So if you're not familiar with that, just go to settings, go to general, scroll down, and you'll have a section that says profile. Go in there, delete it, and then check for an update and you'll have an update. Just go to general, go to software updates, and you'll see that update if you don't have it already. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17B84, and this particular build actually brings quite a few new features along with a bunch of bug fixes. Now there was no modem update for this particular update, but there was a carrier update. I'm on T-Mobile and I did have a carrier update. So maybe you have that, maybe you don't, but with the betas, I didn't really have any connectivity issues. So you should actually see improvements if you're not on the betas. And if you're on the beta, maybe you'll have a carrier update. Now, as far as all the features, all of them apply to iPadOS. I will have a small section toward the end of the video that covers a couple new things specific to the iPad, but all of these updates cover the iPad as well. So the first thing is they've changed a little bit of the way you interact with your home screen apps. So for example, if you 3D or haptic press on an icon, you now have the option to delete the app. So no more do you have to hold down and just keep holding. You can just delete the app. Also, you can hit edit home screen. So if you hit edit home screen, now they'll all jiggle. Now you can continue to hold those if you'd like to do that, and it will do the same sort of action, but it just takes a lot longer. So now it's a little more clear and you can just do that to get out of all of these different apps and get rid of them or whatever you'd like to do. Now, the next thing is Apple has updated the emoji. There's over 70 new emoji to comply with Unicode 12. So let me show you some of them. Now here are all of the new ones. Now there are some differences as far as different skin tones and things like that, but all of these are new. There's different gender equality ones. There's everything from a yawn to some prostheses. You've got a skunk, a flamingo, an onion. You've also got a swimsuit, some ballet slippers, and different colors as well. So these are all new. They're all there and they comply with Unicode 12, like I said. Now there's some changes to the music app, and there's a couple little things here. One of them is if you're in a song, for example, maybe you're in the song here and you pull down while you're in that song, you've now got music history. So if you want to see all the different things you've listened to, you can do that. So again, go back, go to your song that you're playing, slide down, and you'll see all of the different history of different songs. And this syncs up with people that are in your family as well. So they may have some songs in there that you don't listen to, or they may be all of yours as well. Now, the next thing is within music, when you go to share a song, so maybe we'll go and try and share this song, we'll 3D press or haptic press, the menu is a little bit different. Before, it used to be a share sheet that actually slid up. Now this is different and you have what looks like the same thing you get as you get on the home screen when you want to actually delete an app. So you have all of those different options. So they've just changed it a little bit, not a huge change, but it is something to note. Then if we go to the settings app, there's a change there as well under wallpaper. So if we go to our wallpaper here, then choose a new wallpaper, and then we go to live wallpaper, tap on one. It doesn't matter what you tap on. It says live photo on. Then if we tap on it again, live photo off, and then we have perspective zoom on and off. It's just an explanation explaining what's going on. So it's a little bit clearer than it was before, and they've just updated that. And I think that was a good move. Now there's some other changes that are in the settings app as well. So if we go back to settings, then we go to general, we now have a new section for AirPlay and handoff. So let's go into that. And under AirPlay and handoff, it now says automatically play to TVs. You've got the choice for never, ask, or automatic. And then you also have the option to transfer to HomePod or handoff. So this is just a new section they've put here. And along with this update, they've also updated the HomePod and Apple TV. So all of these will need to be updated for all of these different features to work as well. Now there's a new feature that's specific to the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max phones, and that's called Deep Fusion. And this is a way of the phone taking photos in medium light. So for low light or very dark light, there's night mode. For daytime, it just uses the normal camera. But during medium light, it actually uses what's called Deep Fusion. And the way this works is before you hit the shutter button, there's actually zero indication as to what's going on. But before you hit the shutter button, it takes three photos. Then it takes the photo that you just took, and then it takes three more photos after that, all in that instant that you didn't see it. And then what it does is through a process, it takes all of those, combines them, and blends them together for a better image. So now you'll have a more clear image. And many people refer to this as sweater mode because sweaters have a lot of detail in the threads, and you can actually see that a little bit better. So here's a couple photos that I took, and you'll see on the left, it's without Deep Fusion or before the update, and here's one after. Whether or not there's a huge difference is hard to tell sometimes, but it is something that we should see progress. Unfortunately, it is only for this year's phones. Now, something they've also changed specific to the new phones is if you go into video and you see your frame rate and your actual size here, 4K or 1080p, tap on it, you can change it now. But again, this is only for the new phones. You can't do this on anything else. So unfortunately, it's only on the new phones here. There's no reason they couldn't do it on an 8 Plus or one of these phones, but for some reason, you just can't. But that's new to iOS 13.2. Now there's a new setting or a new area in the settings under privacy. And if you go to privacy, you'll see we now have a research setting area. And there's nothing in here. It just talks about research. It says to participate in research app studies or use apps that require sensor and usage data, you'll need to install the research app from the App Store. So if you're participating in a research study, you'll have that section for all of your different settings and things like that. Now, the next update has to do with AirPods. Now, if you didn't see the news earlier today, Apple announced AirPods Pro. They come out on October 30th. They're a new version of AirPods and they have noise cancellation. So this update helps support that, but it also has a couple different changes as well. So if we go into settings and then we go back to or go down to Siri and search, we now have announce messages. And this is something we thought would be in iOS 13, but they pushed out to this one. And what this does is announce when someone texts you through iMessage through your AirPods. So you'll actually hear that text message come in, you'll hear it, it'll read it back to you, and you could either have it reply without confirmation or with confirmation. That way you can reply to it via voice or however you'd like to do that. Now they've also made an update so that if you're using AirPods, let me put one of these in my ear so you can see what I mean. So now I have an AirPod in my ear, and if we pull down into the control center, you'll see that the volume slider now has AirPods in it. Now, if you have Power Beats Pro, those will show there. Also the new Beats Pro Solo should show there, or Beats Solo Pro. And then also if you're playing music, for example, so I'll just hit play on this song and turn it down. You'll see the volume slider animates down here, but what's different is the volume on the side. So now it shows the AirPods and then it animates in and out a little bit differently, kind of swings in and swings out. So if I bring the volume up, it shrinks, bring it back down, it slides out. And then if you wait a second and do it again, it shows up a little bit differently. So it's just a new animation and a couple refinements as well. There's a couple of new things with Siri as far as settings are concerned, and one of them has to do with privacy. So you now have the option to control whether or not to help improve Siri and dictation by allowing Apple to store audio of your interactions. And normally this is used for when you're speaking to it and it gets something wrong. It will actually send that information to Apple anonymously, and then they can correct it and make sure that it works properly in the future. Now, the first time you set up your phone, you're actually going to see that menu. So you'll see here it says share audio recordings. I can't turn the brightness down, so it may be a little bit too bright, but you'll see it says share audio recordings or not now. If you hit not now, you can just get to your home screen. But that option is under Siri in settings. So if you go into settings and then Siri and search, you now have the option for Siri and dictation history, and you can delete it if you agreed to this. If not, you won't have it there at all. So you now have that option to keep your information even more private, which is always good. Now with the iPad, there's a couple small changes as well. So if we go into settings, you'll now see that we have home screen and dock as an option. And under home screen and dock, we have app icons, more or bigger. And this was in a different section before under display, but it was kind of hidden down at the bottom. So now we have more or bigger, keep today view on the home screen. And it just makes things a little bit easier because it puts them all in one place to control your home screen and dock. So if you want to just change it, you can change it back and forth, whatever you'd like. Now there's a small change with Safari as well. So if maybe I open the App Store and then I bring a window over with Safari, let me try that again, and bring this window over, you'll see we have two tabs here, and then we can just swipe them off the screen if we want. It's just a little bit different interaction. Many people were seeing some other ways where there were tabs at the top, one over the other. I wasn't able to reproduce that on this one, but those were some of the changes here. Now, one of the other changes is with the Home app, and this carries across to iPhone as well and all of your different devices, but it now supports secure video. And that means if you have a camera that has secure video support, it will be encrypted end to end and only you can see that, and it's controlled through the Home app. There's also support for new enabled router support. So if you have one of the new HomeKit enabled routers, you could completely control it through here. So that would be really nice. I haven't seen any of those devices myself, but there are a few out there. Now, Apple has also resolved a bunch of issues with this update. So let me go through them quickly. And then after this, we'll talk about battery performance and then some Geekbench scores. So the first thing is they've fixed an issue that may prevent passwords from autofilling in third-party apps. So if you're in a different app and it's not filling, I had this issue myself, that should be resolved. The next one is they've resolved an issue that may prevent the keyboard from appearing when using search. So maybe you're searching here in Spotlight, it's not working. It should be fixed now. Now the third fix has to do with messages when it would only send a single notification, even if the option to repeat the alert was enabled. So if you go into settings and then you go up to notifications and then you go to messages, go down here. Under messages, we have the option to repeat alerts. And if this was set to more than once, it just wasn't showing up for many people. So that should be fixed. It also addresses an issue where messages may display a phone number instead of a contact name. And I've seen this over and over where I might be on my iPhone, then I go to my Mac and the contact name's not correct, or I come to my iPhone, it's just not there, and I re-add the contact, it doesn't show up. That should be fixed in this one. It also resolves an issue that caused contacts to launch to the previously opened contact instead of the contact list itself. So they've fixed that. They've also fixed an issue that may prevent markup annotations from being saved. So maybe you're marking up a photo or a document and it's just not working. Well, if you're marking up the wallpaper, for example, it just wouldn't save. That should be fixed also. They've also resolved an issue where saved notes could temporarily disappear. I've actually not seen notes disappear, but I have seen them not sync properly without closing the app and reopening it. So that should be resolved. And then the next thing is they fixed an issue where iCloud backup might not successfully complete after tapping the backup now in settings. So if you're physically backing it up in your settings, you go into settings and hit that backup button. Now it's working properly. It also improves performance when using assistive touch to activate the app switcher. So if you are using the app switcher with assistive touch, it should be better now. So hopefully all of that's fixed. And that is everything that Apple has said in this update. Now there could be small refinements and tweaks all throughout, but those are the main things that they've mentioned. And then battery life. Well, I've been running the beta mainly on the 11 Pro Max for quite a while. And this is very similar to the previous beta, but it is newer as far as the build goes. But if we take a look at my battery life, you'll see my battery health on this device is 100%, and you would expect that only being about a month or so old. And over the last 10 days, well, it's okay. You'll see 3 hours and 4 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 5 minutes of screen off time. But I haven't even used 50% of my battery with this screen on time. So normally on my best day, I was getting up to 10 to 12 hours of screen on time. If you calculate it out, I've seen differences depending on who you ask, what apps you're using and who's actually using the phone, whether Photos is using this in the background, and Twitter keeps using background activity, even though I have it turned off. So I often have to close that app until it gets updated. Now let's talk about performance, because here I have the iPhone 11 Pro Max. This is performing fine. It's the newest phone. It should be fine. But as far as older devices, I noticed immediately that the older device, such as the iPhone SE, I also have the XR and the 8 Plus here, and I've used it on other devices as well so far, performance seems quite good. In fact, I noticed that opening apps or switching between things and scrolling was just super fast. You'll see things are updating quickly, and this is an older phone. The SE is performing really well. So I definitely appreciate Apple making it still feel fast. You'll see scrolling is fine. There's no stutter or hiccups whatsoever. And then different apps and things. I was using Geekbench. I tested that, and we'll look at that in a moment. But performance on all of these devices seems to be quite good. The XR, while it isn't that old, it's just a year old. Again, I haven't seen a single stutter so far when actually getting ready for this video. So far it's been really good. And then finally with the 8 Plus, it's one of my favorite phones of all time as far as the last generation. And this one, the same thing. You're going to have good performance with this update. Apple's constantly refining these particular updates, and hopefully they'll continue to do that. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores, and I'll show you all of these devices so you get an idea of how they are all across the board. And then you can compare them if you'd like to do that. Now I'm using Geekbench 5, which is the latest version, and the numbers will be a little bit lower if you're accustomed to Geekbench 4. But with iPhone 11 Pro Max, it scored 1,329 for single core, 3,430 for multi-core. This is actually a little bit lower if we take a look at the history. You'll see here's the history from last week. It was 1333 and 3478. It is a little bit lower, but I did run this immediately after I updated it. So just keep in mind that it will get better over time. It's close enough that the performance should be the same. Now let me show you all of these devices as far as the Geekbench scores are concerned. Now on the left, I have the 2018 iPad Pro 12.9. Then I have the iPhone SE, then the iPhone 8 Plus, then the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And if you're anywhere within these numbers, your performance will be fine and there wouldn't be any issue. The only time you'd have lower numbers is if you have low power mode on, or maybe your battery performance is bad and you need to replace your battery. But this should give you a general idea. That's it for iOS 13.2. Hopefully that gives you a good overview of everything new in it, and you may find a few things here and there that I didn't mention. And if you did, please let us know in the comments below. Now, as far as iOS 13.2.1, at the rate Apple's pushing out updates, I wouldn't be surprised if we see that within a week or two with some bug fixes or things like that. Or maybe we'll see 13.3 beta. It's hard to say right now with the way Apple's pushing out updates. But either way, this week we have the AirPods Pro. We'll probably see the MacBook Pro 16-inch along with that Mac Pro as well. So there's some, it seems like we may have a week of reveals this week based on some of the information. Maybe not, but it's looking that way. But let me know your thoughts about it in the comments below. Did you update right away? Let me know there as well. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.